This is the famous fibrillator position, guys. No, no, I remember all, guys. It's very easy. So listen. Now black here will now launch with stockfish. There are three defenses. The defense in the second rank is supposed to be the best, but also there is the defense in the third rank and the first rank. What the books don't say. I will tell you what they say. I will tell you what the books don't say, because guys, my teacher showed me this and I made about 1 year to realize the difference. Listen. Okay. Everybody knows. Listen. All my chickens. Listen how to win this endgame. Listen. When the rook is in the second, listen to the rules that I produced. Listen. When the rook is in the second rank, you play always a waiting move. Okay. Listen. The things you must know about the endgame is like this. You remember. Second rank, waiting move. When the rook is in the third rank, the rule says that in one moment you must give always the check in the king. Can you do this? And when there is the rook in the first rank, you must change wind. Change wind. What this means to play rook b7. If you know the three rules that I tell you, listen to my rules, guys, as a grandmaster speaking. This is a free lessons. Usually I will make only to subscribers this. Okay? I will not use it normally, but okay, just to tell me. So the rules are like this. If the rook is in the second rank, you play a waiting move. If the rook is in the third rank, the solution is always in one moment of the game to play the rook in front of his king. If his rook goes to the first rank, you must change wing. When you change wing, listen, perimeter, duke, listen. You must always use these two lines. So the rule says like this. No. B, G line, and the fourth rank. This. This is the first score you must know. This is the first score you must know in chess. If you know this fourth square in your life, you will be happy. What this means? When you will change the wing, go or a B or G line. If you go to a waiting move from the same line, not to change wing, we don't say to change wing, and maybe you must use the fourth rank. Now, how to win it? Yes. Change wing. I will change wing immediately tomorrow. So, how to win it? If he goes, for example, rook E2, waiting move, rook E1, we say that when he's in the first rank, you change wing. Well, so the move is rook B7. Now, what's the point with rook B7? So, now because you threat mate, clearly for him, the defense is never to move the king. The moving of the king is never a defense, so which means this move is completely ridiculous, because which line you can use? The fourth. Fourth rank. Fourth rank, you see? Fourth rank. Fourth rank. So remember, these four squares, B and C. And now, this is the threat. So, only move for him is rook F1. Not another possibility. How to stop this? If you go rook here, now you can win it with always. Go to the fourth rank like this, threatening mate, king b8, rook a4. This is the simplest way to win his mate. It's simple, everything is winning. Okay, everything is winning, but I know that's the theory, Mitchell, like this. So if he goes this, which is the other thing, no, how to stop this? It's, I don't know how he can defend. Bishop b6 or rook db1 only move. And now, guys, there is a second way. If you don't remember this, because you forgot the B, G, and fourth rank. You also, this move is winning if you want, because there is this technique, which is also winning. If you know this technique is also winning. And you take the rook. Okay, my chickens, listen. Chicken masterclass. So my chickens, listen to this. So when he goes second rank, waiting move, listen to this. He must play in the first rank. When he goes in the first rank, yes, it's very easy. You know, when he goes to the first rank, you change wing. Remember, B, G, and fourth line. Three things. So his move now is rook c1. Now that he went rook c1, now it's time for you guys to remember bishop b3. You must remember this. You must remember this. And actually, sorry, guys, you must remember one move, what to do. And now that the rook is on b3, as we said, this move is never a defense. This is never a defense for him, okay? This is never a defense, because which rank you use? The fourth. And if he goes king d8, my young chicken, you must know rook g4, b, g4th. So you threat mate. So rook e1 is only move, and this is according to Maiato, bishop a4. This is the difficult thing to remember, guys. King c8 and now rook b4. This is the difficult, what you must remember. This is the SOS, this is the difficult thing you must remember. This is the difficult thing. So, but listen to the logic. to read the logic. So, second rank, waiting move. First rank, you change wing. Rook C, king c8 is not a defense, we said. Rook c1, bishop b3. So, this is a difficult thing to remember how to win on king c8. But remember as a rule that the move king c8 is never a defense. I told you. Yes, I told you. Because fourth rank, rook b4. So after rook b4, the endgame is winning, simply. Not simply, but you must know this. So what he must do over here, in general speaking, after rook c1, bishop b3, he must go to the third rank. And I will say that now that the rook is on third rank, now it's completely losing the position, so go bishop e6 back. He must go rook d3, bishop d5. And what rule I told you, when the rook is on the third rank, you must give a check opposite of his king. Check. 1-0. And this check finishes the game. Wherever he goes, you go rook g7, and now the bishop protects the square. Occupation of the square, and now the game is over. Duquesne, you've got it. Especially for you. You've got the method, it's very easy. So listen, Duquesne, listen. Listen to do it fast. Check here, here. Second row move waiting. If he goes to the third rank, check in front of him. If he goes king c8, for example, this is not a move. Rook e7, resign. So only move just to know the field draw position. I repeat last time. Second move, you wait. Remember, B, B, G, 4. Please, can you remember the Gamot? Taxi, it's easy. And taxi, you go rook e1. When the rook is in the first rank, we change wing. Rook f1. And now bishop b3. And now what he will do, see? King c8 is only move. Fourth rank, I told you. Use the fourth rank, I told you. B, G, 4th. King d8 is only move. And now you go to the other side. Okay, this is the difficult thing. And now what? If he goes here, you simply go bishop d5. Threatening mate. King b8. Rook a4. Don't cry for me, Argentina. Thank you very much, Christodoulos Banikas. Okay. My chickens, this was for you, Duki, especially for you, hope you like it. Because you are my favorite subscriber. Thank you. You can see it again in the